proclaim that I'm honored and privileged to be the CEO of the Volunteer Ministry Center, dedicated to ending and preventing homelessness. We're located on the corner of Fifth and Broadway. I appreciate the opportunity to come and share with you our proposed project of permanent supportive housing. Part of the reason that we do so is that we have a track record of almost 10 years of providing permanent supportive housing. And up on the screen is just kind of our values that we do offer a level of compassion, but compassion always has a context, and that context is accountability. And by virtue of that, we have proven that homelessness can be ended as well as homelessness can be prevented. Mandela Manor, we opened in 2010 with 57 units. It is for single men and women. We do have 24/7 property attendants, as well as we have three case managers who are assigned to that location. Their offices are in-house, and their job is to empower the residents to sustain housing as possible. Not only that, we have 24/7 on call, and we have a licensed social worker who directs this program. Individuals who are on the MES and sex offender registry do not qualify for Mandela Manor, and therefore they would not qualify for our proposal here on June 5th. Mandela Manor, as you know, is the old Fifth Avenue Motel.
I can't hear.
We are proud of that project in so many ways. But most importantly, it's been the power to change the lives of those that we serve. One of the handouts that you're about to receive is about Mandela Manor, and the average length of stay of a resident right now is 4.5 years. So we probably have about 20 residents who have been there since we opened in 2010. So it's a very, very effective model of providing care in town. Our future site, we would like to talk about on East 5th, on May. This is kind of the footprint that we were talking about. We don't have any design work right now because we want to be sensitive to the architecture in the community. But you'll see the outline of that. As Becky had mentioned, we are talking to Positively Living about the purchase of that building. We feel like that we could provide great support, but also with this kind of common campus, we can make a dent to those who are experiencing homelessness. We're still in conversation with Positively Living. Hopefully we'll resolve that soon. But anyway, that is our plan. Once again, these 5th will mirror what is happening at Mandela Manor. We'll have we're proposing 47 one-bedroom apartments, once again, for single men and women. Once again, security is very important to us, so there's 24/7. Also, there's clinical staff on site, as well as clinical on call 24/7. As I mentioned, those on the map, as well as the sex offender registry, would not qualify for anything.
Can you speak up?
I'll try to.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you for letting me know. Once again, this is just the layout, the plot of the site plan. And I hope that you'll get a handout of that as well.
The extra space, or are there two separate buildings?
This right here is one building.
Okay. And the Positively Living
is right here.
Is
yes,
separate.
Yes, sir. It's separate.